Hey, kid, I hope you're feeling better. Anyway, I talked with a friend of mine, Richard. He owns a bunch of buildings in Hell's Kitchen, and he's kind of a big shot. Well, the bottom line is he has a cheap apartment that you could probably afford. It's not much, but it'll do. And I also transferred a couple of bucks to your bank account because I want to make sure you get something to eat, okay? Promise me. Hey, kid, I've gone ahead and paid your first rent, but that's it, okay? You need to get out there and get a job. Anything at all. You just need a salary right now. You got a job. Well done. You're a chip off the old block, just like your dad. I think he was probably just about your age when he started his first business. Look, if you need a loan to start something, I got a friend over at Jensen Capital. His name is Larry, okay? That's who you ask for. And be sure to say hi from me, your Uncle Fred, okay? So, you're a gift shop owner now, huh? Yeah, very good. Very good. Now we've got some shopping to do. We'll get you some furniture and some really nice products to sell in there. And I also wanted to mention I recently invested in a car dealership, and we found kind of an old wreck of a car in the workshop in the back, but it still runs. It's not much, but it's yours if you want it. The key's in the glove compartment. Found the car. Good. Now, don't get any parking tickets. As I said earlier, it's time to pick up some stuff for your new store. You're gonna use your new car, or continue running around with the hand trucks. It's up to you. very, very nice. Starting to look like a real store now. Next, we have to buy some things for you to sell. And for the time being, you have to go to a wholesale store. But eventually, down the road, you'll do a whole lot better by importing directly from the manufacturer overseas. Great work, kiddo. Now it's time to open up and start handling some cash, making some money. I'm crossing my fingers. Great work, kiddo. Oh, now it's time to open up and start handling some cash, making some money. I'm crossing my fingers. Well, look at you hustling around and stacking cash already. I tell you, your dad would have been so proud. I think it's time for your first hire. And don't forget to take that course at the Business Administration School so you know what you're doing, all right? Thank you. Well, look at who's the boss. You did a good job on that hire, kid. I know having an employee takes a big cut out of what you're taking in, but it also gives you extra time. Time to, start cleaning up these floors. Oh, man, they're a bit nasty. floors are looking good. Make sure you keep them clean. You don't want the customers walking around in a dirty store, okay? All right, now, back to business. Maybe it's time to start looking for other opportunities. By any chance, have you noticed that people, your customers, are looking for something to drink? How about stock in a fridge or something like that with cans of soda? You can make some extra money on that. There you go, kiddo. Continue listening to your customers and keep improving. Keep improving. And by the way, you know you don't build an entire empire with just a gift shop, right? I think you should consider opening a new business. That said, you don't want to go rushing into something willy-nilly. You gotta know what people want. There's an app for that. Market Insider app. See what people are looking for. Now you know, in business, we always research a market before we go into it. You'll never get rich by supplying products that aren't in demand. Before you start your next business, make sure to get the business administration diploma at the school.
Thank you.
You got two businesses now, huh? I think that's what the media calls a serial entrepreneur. Very nice work. I'll let you get back to it, and I'll catch up with you later, kid.
Thank you. Ah.